One of the hardest parts of studying for the MCAT is figuring out how to start and what techniques to use. The reality is, there are a million different ways to approach this test, and certain approaches work better for certain people than others. It's hard to know exactly what strategies or ways to review content for the MCAT will work best for you at first glance, and it really takes some introspection to understand what your preferred learning style is. Are you a visual learner, an auditory learner, a hands-on learner, or do you find that writing things down helps you more? My name is Vikram Shaw, and in this video, we'll be talking about how to find the best content review strategies that work for your individual MCAT needs, so that you can save yourself time and study for the MCAT as efficiently as possible. First, the two most important techniques to incorporate into your MCAT studying are active recall and spaced repetition. You may have come across these terms before, but regardless of the study strategies we'll discuss today, we'll keep on coming back to these two key concepts. Active recall is defined quite simply as actively stimulating your memory while you study. Examples of this might include asking yourself questions about the content, or forcing yourself to recall the answer without actually looking at the answer. Active recall can be looked at in contrast to passive recall, which may be just reading through your notes. Active recall builds stronger neural connections in your brain, which essentially makes content stick a lot better. In addition, you're able to understand better how various concepts may tie back together, which is something that the MCAT loves to test you on. Spaced repetition is the concept of reviewing content at increasingly spaced intervals to cement information into your mind. Humans tend to forget content pretty quickly if they don't review it over time. However, by using spaced repetition, you can make sure that that content sticks in your brain for the long term. In addition, by getting familiar with commonly used spaced repetition apps, such as Anki, you'll set yourself up well to handle the large amount of content you'll be given when you get to medical school. So now you might be asking, how do I actually use these two concepts in my MCAT studying? How can I apply these to my own content review? This is where your personal learning style comes into play. Let's say you're reading about glycolysis from a review book. If you're a visual learner, you may benefit immensely from seeing the pathway written down, and perhaps also looking at the structures of the substrates at each stage. Then you might draw out the important steps of this pathway every time you review it, and that would really be an excellent way to actively recall the information. To go one step further, you could even ask yourself, what happens to the flux of glycolysis during different metabolic states, such as starvation or post-meal states? To incorporate spaced repetition, draw the important steps of the pathway out every day for a couple days. Then transition to every other day, then maybe twice a week, and then every 2 weeks. And eventually, the pathway will become cemented in your memory. If you're an auditory learner, you may benefit from saying each of the stages out loud after reviewing them as a form of active recall, and then doing this at increasingly spaced intervals as a part of spaced repetition. You may also find that discussing the content with others may increase your understanding of it if you're an auditory learner. Let's say that you're studying a concept that contains more information than glycolysis. If you're studying from a review book, there are different ways to incorporate your learning style into your review. If you're an auditory learner, you may find benefit from reading out loud and stopping at the end of each paragraph, and give yourself time to paraphrase what you've just read. As a visual learner, you may find yourself gravitating towards diagrams and flowcharts, and you may benefit from tying the content you review into those diagrams. For example, if you're studying the renal system, as an auditory learner, you may talk yourself through the different structures that filtrate goes through before being expelled from the body. As a visual learner, you may find benefit in keeping a diagram by your side as you learn about the different structures and then labeling all the parts of that diagram. These are all forms of active recall, and you can notice that they're different than passive recall, which might involve you simply reading and then rereading a textbook. One of the most effective ways to incorporate these study strategies into your notes is to use Anki, which I mentioned earlier. When you create flashcards on Anki, Anki will intelligently decide when to show you the cards, and it takes all of the guesswork out of when your spaced intervals will be. For example, if we think about the glycolysis example from before, you can import a diagram into Anki, cover up the important substrate and enzyme titles, and then test yourself. You can then review these flashcards throughout the course of your MCAT studying. If you find that you learn better when you write down your notes, you may look into using Cornell notes over traditional notes. In this style of notes, you fold your paper into a left and a right section. On the right side, you write down your notes from whatever content you're reviewing, and on the left side, you write down questions about the notes you've written down on the right side. For demonstration purposes, let's say we're discussing hypertonic, hypotonic, and isotonic solutions. On the right side, we would write the definitions of each of them, with a diagram if you're a visual learner. And then on the left side, the question could be, what's the difference between hypertonic, hypotonic, and isotonic solutions? Then, whenever you review those notes, you cover up the right side and try to answer the questions on the left side. If you're a visual learner, you may benefit from writing the answer down. Or if you're an auditory learner, you may find that explaining concepts out loud to yourself helps even more. Then, review the answer and see if you are correct. This approach prevents passive revision of notes and makes sure that you're actively recalling while you study. You would then space out your revision of these notes over time in order to incorporate spaced repetition. You might find that for certain concepts that require more application, physics and general chemistry in particular, you prefer a hands-on approach. While it's recommended to do some general content review before attacking questions, you may find that jumping right into those questions helps immensely for understanding certain concepts. For example, to understand the kinematics equations from physics for the MCAT, doing practice problems that utilize those equations is important to make sure you actually understand how to apply them. This is a form of active recall, and by attempting problems over spaced intervals, you incorporate that spaced repetition. While discussing practice problems, we have often emphasized the concept of perfect practice. Essentially, the idea is that if you were to take a practice MCAT full-length exam and fully review it, 2 weeks later, I should be able to give you that same exam, and you should be able to make a 520 or higher on it because of how well you've mastered the material you previously missed. By completing perfect practice, you're saving a significant amount of time and making your studying much more efficient. In order to do this, we utilize the missed questions log, or the MQL for short. In this log, you should write notes for every question you missed and really go back to the passages to understand why you're missing those questions. Then, using some of the approaches we've outlined above, you should go back and study that material so that you don't miss it again on future tests. There are many study strategies out there, and it's important to realize that sometimes it's worth trying different approaches. For example, if you feel like you're an auditory learner, there may be certain concepts in which you find that a hands-on or visual approach helps you understand that content much better. This is why it's important to give yourself ample time to study for this exam, so you have time to experiment with different methods that may work better for you. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please click on the links below to sign up for our free MCAT question of the day. You can also find free content guides for every section of the MCAT on our site, and we hope you, like thousands of other pre-med students, find these incredibly useful in your preparation. Happy studying.